Hello guys, welcome to my channel Fundamentals of Engineering. In today's session we are going to see tool magazines and work holding devices which are required in CNC machines. Before starting to this session, I request everyone to subscribe my channel, click on bell icon to get more notifications. We are preparing educational videos. If you want to cover any topics, please put that topic name in comment box. If you want to give any suggestions or any feedback, also put that into the comment box. Before starting to this session, tool magazines and work holding device, I like to discuss about these machining centers. So already in the last lecture, we have seen the CNC tooling and machining center. If you want, you can check that in the playlist. Also the suggestion, the link is given, you can check. So the machining centers, the CNC, we are using as an advanced versions of CNC. As we seen, a conventional CNC works with only one tool on one component, but at different locations turn by turn. Eventually all the machine parameters, though at different locations, can generate identical or similar results. But if the part dimensions are changed and the operations which are performed on the workpiece are changed, that different operations we have to perform by the same machines on the same component, then it will be difficult to use the conventional machine. Instead of that, we are using advanced CNC machine, that is a machining centers. This machining centers is having advanced tool magazines and work holding device, so it gives a very good output based on the product manufacturing. So it is having some good ability to machine the part. As we seen, moving the entire magazine here in the machining centers can be done appropriately, and we can bring the appropriate tool near to the tool head to perform the operation. Detaching the tool from the magazine and loading the same at the tool head, removing the tool from the tool head after finishing the concerned operations, and depositing the tool back to the tool magazine but at original pace. That can be done by using these tool magazines. So here all these operations are carried by this instead of operator but automatically. So the tool magazines, it is a system of arrangement which holds large number of tools, so it is called as tool magazine. It is used in CNC turning centers and machining centers to get to reduce the idle time. It has having the storage capacity which range from 12 to 200 tools can be attached. It keeps the tools clean and free from damage. Also it keeps track of which tools are there for by the coding. So we are providing the CNC coding, based on that we can select the tools which are available from the tool magazine, and it can perform the operations very effectively. So based on that, this advanced CNC machine is having a giving the better productivity than the conventional machines due to following reasons. It can accommodate more number of tools which can fed onto the component turn by turn. Hence, complex type of machining operations can be performed easily at the same component setup. It saves multiple setups as compared to the conventional CNC, and hence reducing the work content for repetitive loading, unloading, locating, holding, clamping actions. Since the operations are performed during same setting of the component, interrelations between various machine parameters is more precise. Overall, the machining times gets reduced as compared to the conventional CNC due to using the tool magazines and work holding device. So it is having three types, that is tool turret, drum or disc type, and chain type. So now we are going to see one by one the tool magazine type. First one is a tool turret. It is the simplest form of tool magazine. It consists of tool storage without tool changer. turret is indexed in required position for desired operation. So from the diagram you can see all the operations that turret, different types of tool we can add in this tool turret, and we can easily identify the tool which can perform the operations, and based on that we can give the tool locations in the program. And whatever the tool change time is more, because we have to, whenever the operation is performed, we have to recall back the tool turret back to the normal position, then we have to change the tool turret position for the next operations. For that it will require more time. So in this, first one is a tool turret, next is a drum or disc type. It rotates to get the desired tool in position with a tool change arm. It carries 12 to 15 tools. If the diameter of the disc is large, then we can hold more number of tools. So in the disc, all the tools are attached based on the operation which can be performed on the workpiece, and the tool number is given. Based on that we can call the tools, and we can recall the tools, write the tool number in the program, and based on that sequence of operations we can recall the tool and it can perform the operation. Again, by the rotation we can change the desired tool in position with a tool change arm. So it have pockets where the tools can be inserted. So it having the different pockets where we can insert the tool based on the tool number, and we can recall it to perform the operation. So this is the drum or disc type. Then chain type tool magazine. It is capable of storing more number of tools. Tools are inserted into their pockets which are attached to the chain. Chain moving on sprockets, and sprockets are driven by motors. So in this pockets or the sprockets we are having the chain, and on this chain we are having a different pockets. On this pocket we are inserting the tools with which operations we have to perform on the workpiece. Based on that we can change the tool position by moving the chain or by moving the sprocket, and all these are operated by using the motor. So you can see the pockets, the actual diagram of a chain type tool magazine. You can see here, these are the pockets, this is the chain, and there we can attach the tool based on the operations, sequence of operations we have to perform, and based on the program it will select the tool and it will perform the operations very effectively. Again the tool will be going back to the original position, then the next tool will be called based on the chain moving on sprocket, and it can perform the operations very effectively. So if the tool is worn out, then this tool can be changed easily, and we can insert the tool into the pockets so that all the operation cannot be hampered. So idle time, whatever the idle time, can be reduced. So this is the third chain type of tool magazine. So we have seen types of tool magazine. The next one is a automatic tool changer. The success of machining centers lies in providing the required type of cutting tool out of the bank of the tools available along with the machining center. The efficiency of the provision of the required cutting tool depends upon how fast it can be done and how accurately it can be done. These functions are performed by properly coordinated working combinations of the tool bank, that is tool magazine, and the transfer mechanism, that is transfer arm or shifter arm. Both these units together are called as the automatic tool changers. So all CNC machining centers should have the capability of changing the tools automatically, and the tool magazines which contains tools as small as 6 to 8 in numbers or to large as 50 to 60 in numbers, all these tools can be easily changed. change by using this automatic tool changer. The device used to pick up a tool from a tool magazine and replace it with the tool is in the spindle within 3 to 7 seconds is called as ATC, that is automatic tool changer. So you can see the cutting tool that we have to change. So from the tool magazine we have to take the tool by using this tool changing arm. It will rotate 360 degree and it will collect the tool, and we can change or we can get the cutting tool from the machine spindle. So ultimately the tools can be changed very easily from the tool magazine within a 3 to 7 seconds. So that is the use of ETC. The tool automatic tool changing activity is carried out by in the following order, like transfer arm to move toward the and near to the tool station, pick up the tool, orientation of the tool and moving the same to the tool magazine, tool change magazine to index or to bring the reserve or vacant station for the picked up tool near the tool at the transfer arm, depositing the tool to the magazine. So all these operations are carried out by using this tool automatic tool changer. So it is having some types like turret head, 180 degree rotation automatic tool changer, pivot insertion, multi-axis and spindle direct. So all these activities whatever we have seen earlier are all controlled by the computer with the help of part program. We have to give the part program. Based on that part program, all the operations that pick and depositing the tool to the required position can be done from the tool magazine with this automatic tool changer. Now we are going to see this working of 180 degree automatic tool changer. So first operation, that ATC arms rotates through 90 degree from the rest position. Then art comes to the rest position and grips the both tools. Then one end grips tool in the magazine and other end grips tool in the spindle to pull from the mounting. Then arm rotates through 180 degrees. Then it carries the inserted tools. Then arm rotates and go to the rest position. So this is the automatic tool changer. So all these things that tool magazine and ATC is having a very good characteristics, like tool magazine has to be compact and simple as possible. So automatic tool changer is work with the tool magazine. Interchange of tools should not interfere with the workpiece space and tool space. Easier and safer manual exchange of tool in tool magazine during loading and unloading can be done. All preparatory work for tool exchange should be made during machining, and it is capable of holding enough tools needed for machining. So this automatic tool changer, it works with the tool magazine. So it is having the advantages like simplicity, minimum motion involved, fast tool changes. But it is having some disadvantages, like tools must be stored in a plane parallel to the spindle. Chances of getting chips, coolants on the tool holders. So these are the some disadvantages of the tool magazine with the automatic tool changer. Next one is the automatic pallet changer. So pallet is essential the work holding device. It can principally appear like the table of a milling machine or box shaped table like a drilling machine or even like a angle plate. However, it carries number of slots at right angle to each other, so it can hold some plain or threaded hole mounting on the workpiece. So this is the work holding device and pallet changer. So automatic pallet changer is having the advantages that whenever we want to perform operations on the same part, then that part can be goes into the machine, the operations it performing in the machine, then we can put the next part, whose operation we want to perform next, that we can change on this automatic palette changer. So there we can hold the tool workpiece. Once the operation is done, then the palette is driven back and the workpiece can be moved forward. Then the next whose operation we want to perform then come into the position, then it fed back to the machine. So there we can easily change the work position without disturbing the machining operation. So this is the automatic palette changer. So all the machining centers, that CNC, VMC, are attached with this ATC and APC, that automatic tool changer and automatic palette changer, which having all the jigs and fixtures attached with it, and it can hold the workpiece throughout while the machining, and it can guide the workpiece to the dispatch station. So in this session we have seen the tool magazines, what is the function of tool magazine, what are the type of tool magazines, how the tool magazines is essential in advanced CNC, that HMC and VMC machines centers, why the conventional machines are, we are not, what are the difference between conventional and automatic CNC, how the automatic CNC is benefited to get the more production, that it is reducing the idle time. So that we have seen. Also we have seen the function of automatic tool changer and automatic palette changer, how they are function, what is the significance of this automatic tool changer and automatic palette changer. So in this session we have seen all these things. If you like it, please stay connected and don't forget to subscribe my channel and click on bell icon to get more notifications. If you want to cover any topic regarding the same, please put that topic name in comment box. If you want to give any feedback or suggestion, also you can put it into the comment box. Thank you. Thank you very much.